الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, welcome to our fifth episode of Udhiya Wisdom and Q&A. Inshallah, today I'll be taking two questions, inshallah, or addressing two questions about Udhiya. One is about the time of Udhiya, and the second one is how do you distribute the meat of Udhiya in Qurbani. So the very first one about time, we find from the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he instructed us to perform our Udhiya in Qurbani after performing Salatul Eid. Once a man stood up and he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I have performed the Qurbani prior to Salatul Eid. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that he must repeat his Udhiya or his Qurbani, because once again the emphasis is on performing our Udhiya after the performance of Salatul Eid. Now, it is very important for us to understand that if we are aware or we know that there is a certain butcher house or there is a certain slaughterhouse where they are performing the Udhiya and Qurbani and they're doing it prior to Salatul Eid because they want to save time and so forth, then we have to make sure that we instruct them that no Udhiya or Qurbani should take place prior to the performance of Salatul Eid. Now, there are two important points that I will share with you. And the very first one is, as I said earlier, making sure that whoever is making your sacrifice, making sure that you're telling them that it cannot be done prior to Salatul Eid. That falls on your shoulders. That is your obligation to inquire and to make sure that they understand that it should not be slaughtered. But the second issue, which is a very important issue that many of us, we tend to overlook. Now, before I say this, I want you to understand that in many cases we find that, for example, in America, we do Eid on one certain day, and then we find out that in other countries, they may be or conducting their Salatul Eid on another day. Now, if the day you, as in America, if we are celebrating Eid on one certain day, and the following day, the country where we have sent our Qurbani and Udhiya, and listen to this very carefully, the country where we have sent our Qurbani or Udhiya, if they are celebrating Eid the next day, then there is nothing for you to worry about, because your Qurbani or Udhiya will be done after you have performed your Salatul Eid. But the issue comes into the picture is when we in America are celebrating Eid on the same day that where we have sent our Qurbani or Udhiya, they are conducting and they are celebrating Eid on the same day. Now, I want you to think about this, because wherever we are sending it, whether it may be to some African country or to some Middle Eastern country or some Asian country like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, if we're sending our Qurbani anywhere there and they are celebrating on the same day we are here in America, and they, because of the time difference, they are celebrating Eid prior to us, and they will sacrifice prior to us, then in this case, remember that your Qurbani may be done prior to you performing Salatul Eid here in America. That is why I would strongly suggest that if this is the case, and that it falls once again on your shoulders to inquire about this, but if this does happen, then I would strongly suggest that your Qurbani should be done a little later to ensure that you have performed Salatul Eid, and then your Qurbani is being done after that. So this is the very first thing that we have to keep in mind, which is the time. The second thing, or the second question that many people ask is, how do you distribute the meat? Now, we understand that, and this is a principle rule, that we cannot sell the qurbani meat, we cannot sell the skin of the animal, and even if it comes to the butcher, then we should not pay the butcher with the qurbani meat. In fact, we find from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he instructed Ali radiyallahu ta'ala an very clearly that the butcher will be given a compensation. He will be given some money for his services. So that's why it is not right that if you just give the animal to the butcher, or you give some meat as compensation for his labor work, it is not right, and a separate financial agreement should be in place for his services. Now, as far as the distribution of meat is concerned, as we find from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it should be distributed in three different ways. One distribution, or one part of that share, or it should be divided into three. So each share that you have should be divided into three. One share, or one part for your family, one part for your friends, your families, your neighbors, your relatives, and the last part should be given out in charity. Now, some people have asked this question, that can I keep all of it for my family? And the answer is no, you should not keep all of it for your family, but you should share it with others. The other question that many people ask is that can I just simply give all of it out for charity, especially if I have sent my money overseas and they're going to be performing the sacrifice, can they just give it to people over there? Making sure, once again, it is your obligation to find out that the organization that you are working with, they are honest and they are trustworthy, and they will dispense and they will distribute the meat to the needy people and the poor people. That is something that you need to find out. But if you want to give all your meat into charity, there is absolutely nothing wrong with that. Now, as you all know, of course, that when it comes to shares and so forth, we all know that when it comes to a cow, when it comes to a camel, there are seven shares. When it comes to a goat, a sheep, or a ram, then that is considered as one share. So once again, take each share, divide it into three. Now, if there are several people who are combining and they have seven different shares coming together in a cow or a camel, then in that case, making sure that when the meat is being distributed, the meat should be distributed in the right way. It should not be done by estimation, it should be done by weight. So making sure, because there is no conflict later on, and once again, the shares have to be as equal as possible. So if there is one share where you have all the, for example, mashallah, the juicy meat, but then on one share there's, more bones than the other, then that becomes unfair amongst the shares. That's why it should be a good amount of meat. The meat should be weighed separately, making sure that they all have separate or equal amount of meat, and then the bones also can be distributed equally. Or the people who have contributed the seven shares, they can have an agreement amongst themselves as they wish, but making sure that when it is sacrificed and the meat has been cut, then making sure that it should be all done based on weight, and making sure that, someone may say, well, I'll probably have one share, 15 pounds of meat, and then there'll be 15 pounds of bones. That's not right either. It has to be equal amount of weight and also equal amount of meat and bones. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to do our udhiyah correctly. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more than anything else, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the sacrifice that we're doing for His sake. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
واذكروا الله في أيام معدودات فمن تعجل في يومين فلا إثم عليه ومن تأخر فلا إثم عليه لمن اتقى واتقوا الله واعلموا أنكم إليه تحشرون.